repping well. So final question, what's next for this duo? Another season, more tournaments, the online circuit? How's it going?
Honestly, we don't really like the game that much anymore. Not gonna lie, so we'll see what happens.
Well guys, we are here. After 8 seasons and weekly updates for over a year, Epic still hasn't managed to fix their game. We'll be discussing the recent bug change that has caused chaos all around the Fortnite community. It's evident that Epic has made a multitude of mistakes throughout their development of Fortnite, such as the addition of the boombox or airplane to the game. But what happened this weekend was, without a doubt, one of the most notable and frustrating of them all. This update sent YouTubers like the Orange Guy on a frenzy with tons of new content regarding underground glitches and broken landing spots all around the map. On Friday, April 27th at around 1 a.m., the most well-known and popular landing spot in Fortnite, Tilted Towers, had been met with a horrendous glitch that Epic dubbed the Texture Glitch. Basically, Tilted Towers would not load throughout the entire game, making landing there no longer a viable option. If anyone dared to drop Tilted Towers, their game would be ruined. If players were not aware of this glitch ahead of time, landing in Tilted was basically a death wish. Without any texture on the ground, players had difficulty getting out of Tilted Towers after landing. But this texture glitch has affected more than the start of a game. The first issue was the ability to roam around the affected area. Players were not able to walk around the map like normal, nor were they able to loot the buildings, or even interact with them. That included opening doors, chests, or even pickaxing walls. So, that's pretty bad. But unfortunately, that wasn't all. You'd like to think that the madness stopped there, however, this was not even close to the next bug that the texture glitch brought with it. Many players were actually able to phase through the bottom of the map and hide under the floor of the Fortnite map. This was done by entering a vehicle and driving into Tilted. Once this was done, players would be thrown under the map, but not actually eliminated from the match at all. Based on the storm pattern of each game, some players were awarded with easy wins because others could not find them in the huge mess that was Tilted Towers. All players would have to do is stay inside of the circle to get an easy guaranteed win, while the other players had to fight each other and go through much more just to have a chance at the victory royale. As bad as this is already, we regret to inform you that it does get worse. Not only was Tilted affected, but also Retail Row. Yes, the two landing spots that are the most popular amongst all parts of the map in Fortnite. Despite the two most popular landing spots in Fortnite not functioning correctly, the majority of the player base wasn't even informed of this issue. Many thought that this glitch was not actually an issue with the game, but an issue with their platform. Usually when textures don't load in the beginning of the game, it's simply an indication that a player's device is wearing out, since it cannot process the textures as quickly as before. This fact caused many people to believe that their PCs, consoles, or even mobile phones were wearing down and needed to be replaced. God knows how many people have returned their products or even bought new ones during this time. Basically, it created mass paranoia in the Fortnite community, but that's not even mentioning the timing. The worst part of it all was that it was right before the qualifiers for the Fortnite World Cup. This made a ton of people worried about their chances at qualifying to win millions of dollars. So it added to their questioning of whether their device was capable of loading in textures during a game, which ultimately resulted in people making hasty generalizations about their hardware. This does get worse though, trust me. Epic also failed to acknowledge this glitch to their player base until it was too late. They only gave out a public announcement of the bug way after it was patched. Therefore, players who were playing during this time had no idea what was happening until they loaded into Tilted themselves. Some people saw a tweet or Reddit post, but that wasn't efficient enough. In fact, many players were left in the dark, literally. Taking all this into consideration, we can only conclude that Epic has once again shown us that they are incapable of doing the right thing. With a recent nerf to Siphon in Fortnite, a vast majority of the player base argued and complained for the removal of Siphon altogether. Many large influencers in the Fortnite scene, such as Ninja, ran polls asking their fan base what they thought of the changes. And without surprise, in every poll, the percentage of people who wanted Siphon back was way over 80%. Millions of people had voted in these polls, and it became quite evident that the majority of Fortnite fans hated this change. The way Epic deals with this, however, was simply by making a statement claiming that the majority of players did not like Siphon in the game, yet they provided absolutely no evidence or proof for their claims. Meanwhile, the Fortnite community had gathered enough information to debunk this claim. To us, it appears that Epic is out of touch with the Fortnite community completely. We hope that with all these mistakes, Epic will at least learn how to deal with these types of situations in the future. But if they continue with how they have been recently, there is no doubt in our minds that the company will begin to fail. And their flagship title, Fortnite, will go down with them. As we reach the end of the video, we'd like to ask you guys what your thoughts are on this situation. How should Epic have addressed such a major game-changing glitch? What do you think Epic can do better next time to improve their game? Please be sure to like the video and subscribe so you can stay updated on the latest Fortnite tips, tricks, and metas. If you guys are interested in getting better at Fortnite, then please check out ProGuides.com, where we have the best guides with your favorite pro players like Mongrel. Thank you all so much for watching, and good luck in your next games.